After Labour's shocking local election results, Keir Starmer told MPs he would spend the summer speaking to people who weren't sure whether to vote Labour, not speaking to crowds of the faithful. Now, this was widely reported and interpreted as a rebuke to Jeremy Corbyn, who people argued could rally the troops, but not appeal to swing voters. Keir Starmer saying, I'm not interested in rallying the troops. I'm interested in those swing voters because I'm interested in government. Now, in response to Starmer, many on the left replied that even if a Keir wanted to give rallies to the faithful, he'd struggle to assemble any crowds. On that front this weekend, Starmer provided us with a test case, with some evidence. That's because Keir Starmer spoke to the Progressive Britain Conference. We can get up the tweet and the advert here. Now, Progressive Britain is a tie-up, a merging of Progress, which is the Blairite faction in Labour, and Policy Network, which is a sort of small centrist think tank run by Peter Mandelson. So this is very much a rally to the faithful. I mean, Peter Mandelson essentially advises Keir Starmer, even if in an informal capacity. The Blairite faction backed Keir Starmer in that leadership election. So this is not a rally to people who Keir Starmer disagrees with. However, Starmer did keep his word when he says he wouldn't speak to crowds of the faithful because there were no crowds watching this. We can take a look at a screenshot of the Zoom call with Keir Starmer, the headline act. 55 people were watching this. So you can see there in the top left-hand corner, you can see 55 people were viewing this. This is the guy who's supposed to be the next prime minister, the leader of the Labour Party. 55 people watched it, or at this point when this screenshot was taken at least. Presumably, some of those viewers were also journalists. That's because it was written up in The Guardian. Keir Starmer vows all new Labour manifesto and economic offer. Party leader says new blueprint for power will not draw on those of either Jeremy Corbyn or Tony Blair. This is a reference to what Keir Starmer was talking about, which was Labour's new policy review. The policy review was launched after the local elections. It's supposed to feed in to Labour's next manifesto. It's kind of a response to everyone saying, you've got no policies. What do you stand for? Say, oh, we'll have a policy review. You know, it will help us look outwards to the country. The Guardian explain what he said about this. So the review led by the new party chair, Annalise Dodds, would not take the 2019 manifesto as its launch pad, Starmer said. You don't go through a review like this by picking up the last document. Now, at this point, you might say, so what? You know, why should a party leader use a previous manifesto or previous manifestos as a starting point for new ones? You know, isn't it better to start from scratch and to say, we don't have to be tied to previous positions we took. Let's just look at what the best positions are and put them in a manifesto. Now, that would be a coherent argument. You know, I personally would draw from the 2017 manifesto at least because I think it has been tested, you know, in an election and it was popular and people liked it and it was quite coherent. And I think it was, you know, much more successful than the one that came before it. So I would start from the 2017 one, but you can make a coherent argument that you should start afresh. The problem is that Keir Starmer is in no position to make that coherent argument because when he was trying to get votes from Labour members, Starmer himself said he would take previous manifestos as the starting point for the next one. Let's take a look.
Jeremy Corbyn made our party the party of anti-austerity, and he was right to do so. The party that would fight cuts to public services. He made us the party that wanted to invest more heavily in our public services, and he was right to do so. And we must retain that. We build on that, we don't trash it as we go forward. We should treat, if you like, the 2017 manifesto as our foundational document. The radicalism and the hope that that inspired across the country was real. Anybody who knocked on a door in that election knows it was real. So we have to hang on to that.
So this is a guy, Aaron, who is just chronically dishonest, isn't he?
He's got major problems, Michael. You know, people say, is Keir Starmer a Corbyn supporter? Is he a Blairite? I mean, he's none of the above, you know. I really wish it was that simple to categorise what he believes in. Keir Starmer believes in Keir Starmer being the leader of the Labour Party. And at the beginning of 2020, that meant saying some things which appealed to those who'd previously supported Jeremy Corbyn. What we can see from the weekend and briefings over the last few weeks is that he's very happy to adopt a policy program actually to the right of Tony Blair. I mean, I'm not even joking. Tony Blair had Gordon Brown. Gordon Brown certainly didn't want, for instance, reductions in corporation tax in the long term. He thought certain taxes could go up. So funding the NHS in the early 2000s, huge influx of cash into the NHS under New Labour, indisputable. Where did that come from? It came from increases in things like national insurance contributions, increasing duties on things like alcohol, cigarettes, fuel, etc., etc. You can say they're progressive or regressive taxes. That's by the by. They were funding public services, which improved to an extraordinary extent. I don't even think Keir Starmer would go that far. I think Keir Starmer, as we're seeing right now, actually, in the whole corporation tax debate, clearly the Labour right is to the right of the Tories on economic policy. And clearly Keir Starmer is tying himself to those same people, because first he thought it was enough to get him elected as Prime Minister. As it becomes increasingly obvious he hasn't got a clue, he needs to tie himself to them merely to retain power and political leadership of the Labour Party. So it is deeply concerning, because it's a man who believes in nothing, has no integrity, has no values, and has no charisma. In short, we're looking at the political equivalent of a black hole. Nothing is coming out. It drags any light into it. So to call him a Blairite or anything else, I don't think is accurate. It's somebody who believes in nothing except the pursuit of power. Only problem for him is he's not very good at it. Just look at his polling.